question is complete. So let's save this with Control S, and now I'm running this program and checking. So our program is successfully run, and there is a output here is a prime or not a prime. But something wrong here. Let's see in the program to find the prime. So there's no option to. Oh, let's see, whole program is any mistake. Public class find prime, it's correct. Then static void main is correct. Then int num, boolean is prime, num is 14 if num is less than 2, is prime equal to false, else is prime true. For int I is equals to 2, else, oh, I forgot to write here else, that's why it's printing the both else system.println. Now what is the error here? Oh, here is if is prime, if is prime. So let's save this program and to project and running the file. So the output is 1 to 4. So this is used as a comma operator. So I can write here in comment using the comma. So let's do another program. And this is using the comma, preceding for loop can be more efficiently coded. So the next last program is, we are not using comma, but we are showing. Now we use this. Now using the comma, so we are taking the class name is comma, so it will be clear for you. Base 4. Then A is less than B, and incrementing A, A here, and decrementing b. So you can see how we can using comma here. So now we are here, system.println dot out println. So it's here. So see, where is the problem in the program? A initialize it 1, or we have no space. A is initialized with 1 and b is with 4. A is less than b, then a incrementing and b decrementing, and everything is right here. So let's go above. Public static void, the spelling is incorrect, that's why it's showing error. Now here is also the problem is so we are using two places comma. Showing why it's showing error. Let's see. Expected. So let's save this and run this program and see what is the output. Showing error. Let's go again. I'm not finding out the error is here. Expected. Where it's expected. Empty statement. I can't find out the empty statement here. So let's see the output. Save this package. Taking time for running the program. Something wrong in it. Class name is forward because we are showing the variation in loops. So here public static void main. String args and this. So let's declare the variables. Here I'm declaring variable in variable I and boolean means true and false. Yeah. Boolean done equal to false, and I is initializing I is 0. Then for loop, here is a for loop, and done. And you can see the variations of, I will write here, parts of the loop can be empty. Now print it, system dot out dot print ln, print ln. So I want to print here is I is there is plus so here is I. Then if I is equals to 10, done is equal to true. So here is the conditions, where we use conditions in a by the help of control statements. So here is the if is here, if is equal to true. If is equals to true, then we are incrementing I here outside. So let's see what's the problem here. Public static void main string. The silly mistakes out there. Illegal start of type alt enter. Public. It's correct. Here is the three for where no public something wrong, but I'm not able to see what is wrong here. So let's see, save this program and see the difference. It's showing the error. So something wrong or a big mistake. So let's see, where is the mistake? Showing error in this statement. And what is the error? I can't find out. Public static void main string args. Everything is correct here. So here is our output, and output is correct. Here I is 0, 1, 2, 10. But what is the use of false here? True or false? System.print I is plus I. If I is equals to 10, done true. If I and then increment. There is not showing any true or false here. Here is if boolean done equal to false, everything is correct, because if I is equals to 10 is true, then it's printing 1 to 10. Okay. So let's go to now the for each version of the for loop. Here, use of for is type for loop. So it's a simple program. And we are taking the class name is for each. For each. So here we are so let's see, here is int and data type, and we are using arrays, nums. Let's write all the numbers here. Array. Int sum is equal to 0. Use a for style for to display the sum values. Display and sum the values. Why it's showing? Because I used here. Don't know why it's showing here error, because it's the comment. This is comment. So let's use here for here is int x num then printing here value is plus x and here summation. Plus sum and let's write here what is sum. The sum is equals to plus equals to x. Let's save this and run this program. Sum is 55 and it's printing from 1 to 10. It's correct. Let's do another program. Use break with for each style for. So we are using break with for each. So our class name is here for each 2. We can use the same program and do some changes in that. So it will save our time. For each 2, so we have to do a change here. Use for display and sum the values int x and I have to change if x is equal to 5. I want to change only the one statement here, and this is if x is equal to 5, then break. Stop the loop when 5 is obtained. So we are writing in comment. Stop the loop if 5 is obtained. And summation of first 5 elements. First 5 elements and everything will be same. So let's save it and see the difference. So it's printing 1 to 5 and then break and summation of 5 statements. So it's good to use break, and you can learn here how you can break this. Now next is the for each loop is essentially read only. Class, no change here. So no effect on nums here. So let's see how we can do this. Program name is no change. So we will do the program here same, because few changes are there, so we don't waste time in writing all same thing again and again. So I am using this program, no change. So here the for each loop is essentially read only. Read only. So in this program everything will be same except this. Here x equal to x into 10 and system dot println. Here is, there's no summation here, so I will leave it blank. No effect on nums. No effect on nums. So it's a comment. then all changes are here. For we are taking here for. For x is equal to num. Nums, then system dot print along x plus and we are removing comma from here. Okay, then system dot print ln. Let's see the difference here in the output. Let's run this program. So it's printing 1 to 10 here. Value is 1 to 10 here. Now everything's fine. Now program will run as we think about the output, run according to it. So it's printing 1 to 10 two times. So our next program is iteration over multi-dimensional array. This program is of single dimensional array, and it's a now our next program is on multi-dimensional array. And program name is for each 3. For each 3, then here first statement is public static void main string args. Then int sum equals to 0. Then int num multidimensional array. I already done few questions, but it is with for each. So new int this size is 3 here. Size is 5. Then nums I and j. I'm taking a for using here for loop. In for loop, declaring int here, and its value is 0. And I less than 3. Then increment I. J plus 1 nums I J I plus 1 into J plus 1. Here is bracket. Close. Then use for each to display the sum of the value. For int x, name. Equal to nums. For int y, y and x, then system dot println. Dot out print ln. Your value is 1. Is plus y, then sum y. Same, this is the same question which we've done earlier. First difference is here is we are using multi-dimensional array. the summation. So let's save this and run this. Or we have to run one more loop here. It's here we are using j equal to 0 and j less than 5, and here is 5. Save it and run this one. This one is not. Everything's good. It's already saved. Why it's showing error? Oof. Was it not saved? No, change version. Because here is J, or I am writing here I. That's why it's wrong, showing wronger. Now project is correctly run here, and sum is 19. Now applying. Now our next program is search an array using for each style for. Program name is search. So let's do the program. public int nums. It is a single dimensional array, but we are doing here search. So let's write here in the comments what we are doing here. Search an array using for each style. So here is array. Let's initialize the variable here. Write the variable. These are not variables, these are numbers in arrays. 6, 8, 3, 7, 5, 6, 1, 7. Then int value equal to 5, then boolean found equal to false. Then use for each style for to search nums for value. Search nums for value. Then for, we are using for loop here, for int x and num nums, then found equal to true and break, found equal to break. Now our question is complete, but here is, we have to write here if found then here is our print statement. System dot out dot print ln. So here is value found. Value found. If there is no space in if, and if is capital. Value found. Public static. Wait a minute. Let's save this and run it. So value found is our output. So our next program is nested loops. We will do a one program in nested loops, then we will go to jump statement using break to exit a loop, all this. So let's go to jump statement, nested loops. Nested. We will take a class name here, nested. Nested. So loops may be nested. Public static void main. String args. Declare the variable here int I and j. Then we are using for loop for i's equals to 0 and I is less than 10, then incrementing. Let's do this same for J. First we have to replace here. System.out, system.out println. Then again, we don't need to write anything. So let's save this and run this program. It's a very simple program. I think there is no error, but one error is showing. Save this again and run this program. Let's see what is the output here. Output is showing here. It's not correct. So let's see what mistake I have done, because it's showing a dot but not in a sequence, not in the way what I assumed. So public class stating this is correct, int ij is correct, I is less than 10 and j is less than 10, but here is no space, so let's make some space for it and see what is the mistake I've done here. One racket, two, that's two rackets, three, everything is correct, that's no problem. J is equal to I hai, J is equal to I. Now, I hope my program will run correctly as I think. No, something wrong, we have to change. Check again the program. Ij is correct, then for I is equal to 0 and I is less than I plus plus is correct, j is equals to I, j is less than 10 and j plus plus incremented. Okay, system dot out print ln is this, then system dot out print ln is this. So where is the error? I can't see. Should I write one more? Let's see what will happen. No change in my output. It's looking the same. I is less than 10. J is also less than 10. So it will print like 1, 2, 3 to 10. If j is equals to I, then j will also do the same. And let's remove this because there's no change after doing this. Oh, it's very slow process to finding errors. I can't find any error here. I think my program is correct. Something wrong. Video is very long, so let's do another more programs in our next video.